Hello video creators, it's Deepak Verma again and welcome back to our channel. Today we are going to learn something very common. Almost everyone uses it and that is whip pan transition. Check this out. So that is what we're going to do today. Well, it's time to do editing. So let's jump onto Premiere Pro. So here we are in Premiere Pro. I already have two footages side by side, which I'm going to use in this demonstration. Now, first create an adjustment layer, either by going to File, New, Adjustment layer, or simply do it from here. Click it, adjustment layer. Settings are good to me. Let's just hit OK. So we have our adjustment layer. Now let's drop it above the clips. So first, come in the middle of the two clips. Go 3 frames to the left and cut. Now again, come in the middle. This time go 6 frames to the right and cut. We want little extra frames on the right side to make the transition more smooth. The thing is that it should start fast and around the end it should get slow. That's what looks better. Well, we are done with the adjustment layer. So now it's time to add some effects. For that, go to the effects panel and search for offset. Now drag and drop this effect on the adjustment layer. Now go to the effect controls and look for offset. Here it is. Basically, we need to offset the x-axis. If you notice, while I'm changing the values, it's basically repeating the frame. And that's what we need. In order to do it properly, come to the beginning of the adjustment layer and hit the toggle animation for Shift Center 2. It will add a keyframe with the default value. Here we have our x-axis at 960. Now go to the end of the adjustment layer and add another keyframe. But this time change the x-axis to -960. Now if you play it, we already have motion here from one clip to another. But the next thing we need is to apply some blur. So go to the effects panel and look for directional blur. Drag and drop it on the adjustment layer. Now go to the effect controls and look for directional blur. So first, go to the beginning of the adjustment layer and hit the toggle animation for blur length. It will add a keyframe with zero blur length, means no blur. Now go to the middle of the two clips and add another keyframe. But this time change the values to around 200. And finally, go to the end of the adjustment layer and click the reset parameter. It will add another keyframe with a default value that is 0. Basically, through the adjustment layer, we are moving from no blur to blur in the middle and then back to no blur. Now let's play it. Nope, we have a problem here. Blur is coming in a vertical format and that's not what we want. Let's make it horizontal by changing the blur direction from 0 to -90. Now play it. There you go. But have you guys noticed what is missing here? It's the sound effect. So let's add a whip whoosh sound effect while the transition is happening. Sound effect that I'm using here is from Epidemic Sound. I have mentioned their link in the description below. You can check that out. Well, let's keep the sound effect in the middle of the two clips and now play it. That's it. Here we have our whip pan transition. I hope it was useful for you guys. If it was in any way, give a thumbs up to this video or leave a comment and make sure to hit the subscribe button if you're new here. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Take care and goodbye.